Ibrutinib is an antineoplastic agent used to treat chronic lymphocytic leukemia, mantle cell lymphoma, and Waldenstrom's macroglobulinemia. In this video, let's find found. What is ibrutinib? What is ibrutinib used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking ibrutinib? How does ibrutinib work? How to use ibrutinib? What is ibrutinib? Ibrutinib, sold under the brand name Imbruvica among others, is a small molecule drug that inhibits B-cell proliferation and survival by irreversibly binding the protein Bruton's tyrosine kinase. Blocking BTK inhibits the B-cell receptor pathway, which is often aberrantly active in B-cell cancers. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. What is ibrutinib used for? Ibrutinib is indicated for the treatment of the following conditions. Chronic lymphocytic leukemia, CLL/small lymphocytic lymphoma, SLL. In the US, it is used in adult patients with or without 17p deletion. In Europe and Canada, it is used as a single agent or combined with rituximab, obinutuzumab, or venetoclax in previously untreated CLL patients. In patients who have received at least one prior therapy, it is used as a single agent or in combination with bendamustine and rituximab. Waldenstrom's macroglobulinemia. It is used alone or with rituximab. In Europe, it is approved for patients who have received at least one prior therapy or in first-line treatment for patients unsuitable for chemoimmunotherapy. Chronic graft-versus-host disease, CGVHD. In the U.S., it is approved in patients aged 1 year and older the prior failure of one or more lines of systemic therapy. In Canada, it is approved in adults with steroid-dependent or refractory CGVHD. Mantle cell lymphoma, MCL. In Europe and Canada, ibrutinib is also indicated to treat relapsed or refractory MCL in adults. Marginal zone lymphoma, MZL. In Canada, it is approved for adults who require systemic therapy and have received at least one prior anti-CD20-based therapy. Contraindication. Imbruvica is contraindicated in patients who have known hypersensitivity, e.g., anaphylactic and anaphylactoid reactions, to ibrutinib or to the excipients in its formulation. Use of preparations containing St. John's wort is contraindicated in patients treated with Imbruvica. Side effects. Very common, greater than 10% frequency, adverse effects include pneumonia, upper respiratory tract infection, sinusitis, skin infection, low neutrophil count, low platelet counts, headache, bleeding, bruising, diarrhea, vomiting, inflammation of mouth and lips, nausea, constipation, rash, joint pain, muscle spasms, musculoskeletal pain, fever, and edema. Common, 1 to 10% frequency, adverse effects include sepsis, urinary tract infection, non-melanoma skin cancer, basal cell carcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma, low leukocyte count, lymphocyte count, interstitial lung disease, tumor lysis syndrome, high uric acid levels, dizziness, blurred vision, atrial fibrillation, subdural hematoma, nosebleeds, small bruises from broken blood vessels, high blood pressure, hives, and skin redness or blushing. Pharmacodynamic. In clinical trials for relapsed/refractory diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, a partial response was found in between 15 to 20% of the patients studied, while for patients with relapsed/refractory Waldenstrom's macroglobulinemia, a partial response was observed in over 75% of the patients tested. Finally, for patients with relapsed/refractory follicular lymphoma, a partial to complete response was obtained in approximately 54% of the patients. Mechanism of action. Ibrutinib is an inhibitor of Bruton's tyrosine kinase, BTK. It forms a covalent bond with a cysteine residue in the active site of BTK, Cys481, leading to its inhibition. The inhibition of BTK plays a role in the B-cell receptor signaling and thus, the presence of ibrutinib prevents the phosphorylation of downstream substrates such as PLC-gamma. Half-life. The elimination half-life of ibrutinib is approximately 4 to 6 hours. Dose. Chronic lymphocytic leukemia/small lymphocytic lymphoma. also indicated for CLL/SLL in patients with 17p deletion. Monotherapy or in combination with rituximab or obinutuzumab, or with bendamustine and rituximab, BR, combination 420 mg POQ day. Continue until unacceptable toxicity or disease progression. Waldenstrom macroglobulinemia. Indicated as monotherapy or in combination with rituximab. 420 mg POQ day. Continue until disease progression or unacceptable toxicity. Chronic graft versus host disease. Indicated for chronic graft versus host disease, CGVHD, in adults who failed one lines of systemic therapy. 420 mg POQ day. Continue until CGVHD progression, recurrence of underlying malignancy, or unacceptable toxicity. Safety advice. Based on these findings in animal reproduction studies, it can be extrapolated that ibrutinib can cause fetal HRM when administered to pregnant women. The FDA has designated this medication pregnancy category D. That's all the information about ibrutinib we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.